So, how about that?
Hitbox.
If we're talking technical terms, a hitbox is defined as an invisible box-like area that, if penetrated, counts as a hit. Now, there's a difference between the character model and its hitbox. Character models that offer higher levels of topology and detail will have more complex hitboxes, usually incorporating multiple boxes to cover each part of the body. In Hogs of War, though, the hitboxes are extremely basic. To actually see them, we need to take a look at Hogs of War Reheated, as this was the only time I was and have ever been able to see the game's hitboxes. So let's start with the pigs. As you can see, their hitboxes are a singular cube that doesn't actually cover the entirety of the model. Now, the model's design in Reheated is different to the original, but the pigs' pose and their hitboxes are near enough identical. Meanwhile, the palm trees also appear to have singular hitboxes, which means that the leaves that you normally find at the top have no collision. Speaking of trees, other types of foliage in Hogs of War have different size hitboxes, some appearing to jut out more than others. But how exactly would I describe the pig's hitboxes? In one word, how would I sum up these invisible rectangles? Forgiving. Very forgiving. Take for instance this prime example. This clip is from about a week ago where myself, Caster and Bobby were playing some multiplayer. I had to.
Okay, now you're out of there.
Tick tock, get a move on. Back to your own country.
A couple of toes.
No, it's fine.
Miss.
Now if we look at this shot slowly, you can see that my crosshair was ever so slightly too far to the right. But at the time, I was convinced that it was going to hit. And that's where things start to get a bit tricky. As obvious as it may sound, at long range it becomes harder to hit pigs, as you are required to be more accurate and should primarily aim for the center part of the enemy pig. However, sometimes it may feel like that rule doesn't exactly exist, as you'll see from this next clip.
Oh,
perfect. Sniping's a good job, mate.
Oh, if you land this, oh, I can just about see him.
Okay, maybe we'll
You can barely... There's like a pixel where his hat is.
Yeah.
If that hits, I swear to God, hitboxes are ridiculous.
Okay. You're running out of time.
Quick!
Under pressure.
Quick!
I can just see an ear poking out.
Ooh.
We'll see that. Insane.
No, come on!
No. Oh boy.
What are hitboxes?
Okay.
That would have gone through my hat, and he would have been fine.
Yeah.
Going in the video.
Can I recommend a slow motion of that shot?
Once again, if we take a closer look at this clip, you can see that his crosshair was lined up with what I can only presume to be the center of my pig. But to be fair to Caster, it was an extremely good shot, especially considering how he was running out of time. As you saw from the view of the hitboxes earlier, it seems that the pig's arms appear to stick out of the main hitbox for the body. So any shots that aim close to these areas tend to pass right through. From the side, things are more forgiving, as the butt area of the pig is in the center of the pig's hitbox. Even shooting near the arm seems to penetrate. As we've already mentioned, distance requires more accuracy in your shot, but you know, if you slow down the footage, you can actually see where the bullet hits the pig. Also, if I slow down this clip, you can get a better view of the bullet projectile actually passing through the pig model. Best advice, don't aim for the arms. Of course, the angle you happen to be aiming at can also affect whether the bullet ends up hitting its mark. For instance, here, I was aiming for his face, and it ends up hitting his arm? I don't know. One thing we haven't factored in yet is the bullet's projectile size. The sniper rifle bullets are actually much bigger compared to other weapons like the rifle or the pistol, which is what helps make it so damn accurate. Take this clip for instance. I deliberately aim out away from this grenadier, but as the projectile gets near the pig, you can see how the scale between the pig and the bullet is quite drastic. So what happens if a pig becomes injured? Well, the pig's character model changes its pose, so surely the hitbox changes too, right? Nope. From what I can tell, it actually remains in the same place, so even if the pig is hunched over with its head facing down, the hitbox remains in its default standing position, which means that you can aim for where the head used to be and still hit a successful shot. So in conclusion, hitboxes in Hogs of War are weird things. I know we've only really focused on bullet-based weapons in this video, but in future we'll be talking more in depth about other areas like splash damage and explosive weapons. But what are your thoughts on this subject? Let me know in the comments, and in the meantime, I will catch you guys later for the next one. Destination.